peace and conflict resolution. Law, peace and conflict resolution. Laws in Kenya are governed by the constitution. We are governed in Kenya, we are governed by a constitution. By a constitution. Here is where, in a constitution, is where we get laws. Those laws are made by the parliament. We talked about parliament, the work of the parliament are made by the parliament. Laws are debated by the members of the parliament. Here are members of parliament, not the parliament. Parliament is a building. So those members of the parliament. And the one who debate these laws, then they are written in the constitution. This is where they govern the country. Each and every individual is under the constitution of Kenya, meaning each person has to respect this constitution, where the constitution, these are the laws. These are the laws. Even the president of Kenya is under the constitution, the laws of Kenya. Recently, the constitution, when they want to change the constitution, maybe to favor a particular place, they have first to go to the parliament, they debate about that constitution to change it so that they can maybe favor the people. So the president has no right. The president will only sign after it has been debated by the members of the parliament so that it can change. So these are the laws that govern a country. So, and people who break these laws, people who break the laws are taken to court. They are taken to court. If you are found maybe stealing, which is not a part of the constitution, is not a law. Laws are rules. These are rules. Even in the traditional society, there were rules that were being followed by those people. So they were laws, even in traditional African society. It's not now only, they were also rules. If the person breaks these rules, there was severe punishment for that. So we are saying these laws are rules that are followed by everybody in the government of Kenya. So we have to obey these laws. And if you don't obey the laws, that is where we get lawlessness. Lawlessness. Meaning, people who do not obey the laws, people who do not obey the laws, there will be no peace. Here there will be no peace. No peace, and people will be living. You cannot live in a certain place due to the lawlessness in that peace and harmony in the country. There will be no peace and there will be no harmony in the country. There will be conflict. Conflict meaning people fighting one another, maybe fighting, stealing, killing one another. Killing. That is the main risk. That is lawlessness. When there is no peace, these are the results. If there is no peace in a country, we get people fighting, killing one another. Reason being, people do not follow the laws. They do not follow the rules. And rules, I'm saying, rules are laws. Rules are the laws in a country that everybody has to follow. And if we do not follow, there will be no peace. And if there is no peace, that is where we say the state of lawlessness. There is no peace in a country. So what causes lawlessness? What causes lawlessness? What causes lawlessness? I've told you, lawlessness is where laws of the country are not respected. Lawlessness. Is where laws, rules, let me say rules, no rules that are being for respected. So what causes this lawlessness? Why should people fight? Why should people steal from one another? One is that high rate of unemployment. High rate of unemployment. If many people are not employed, especially youths, if they are not employed, they look for ways of getting money, and here the ways of getting money is either by stealing. So there will be no peace in that area because many youths or many boys and girls do not have, they are not employed. And if they are not employed, they find ways of getting money. So the area, there will be no peace in that area. There will be lawlessness in that area. That is one. High poverty. High rate. That is also another result where people are not well off. Many people are poor. Many people are poor. They find a way of getting how to live and how do I, can I get? You see, in many areas in the evening, even in our areas where we live, you cannot walk at night. They tell you the security of that place is not maybe good because many people are poor, so they have to find a way of living. Either that way of living is by stealing. So that is result, that is another. We also have religious difference. Religious difference is where, example, we have the Christians versus the Muslims. The Christians versus the Muslims fighting one another. We have in other countries, you cannot find Christian churches there. In areas where maybe there are a lot of Muslims, you find it's very difficult to find Christians there. They are being killed because of their religion, or Christians killing the Muslims because of their religion. That is also another reason. We have the fourth one is tribalism. Tribalism. This is where like in general election, this mostly happens in general elections or in election, let's say just elections. Elections. Here, example in 2017, 2020, there, most of the people were being killed because of their tribe. When, example, people living in Mombasa are start fighting the people who are not born here in Mombasa, who they believe that they are not from the tribe of the maybe Mijikenda or Swahili. So they are being chased away, being killed because of their tribe. We also have the Kikuyus. Maybe they have the Kalenjins living in the Kikuyu area. So the Kikuyus will start killing the Kalenjins because of their tribe. Or maybe the Kalenjins killing the Kikuyu because of their tribe. This mostly happens during the election. We also have another reason. Why should there be no peace? Why should there be a lot of lawlessness in the country? Where should they be? We have another practice of being intolerant. We have another use of mob justice. Use of mob justice. This is another reason for another cause of lawlessness where many people are being killed when someone, maybe one person has stolen a phone somewhere or just a system somewhere. People can think that maybe he's stealing. So a lot of people killing someone can cause lawlessness. Then the people of the, maybe the relatives of the person organizes, they also organize themselves and they go and kill the tribe or kill the, start killing people because they want to take revenge that there was mob justice somewhere that happened. And this mostly happens in town where like the thieves, one of the thieves, one thief may be killed through mob justice. After being killed, these people now, the fellow gangs will come up in that area and start killing people because they want to take revenge for their one person who was killed. That is mob justice, can cause lawlessness. Violation of human basic human rights. Violation of basic human rights. Violation of basic human rights. This is like denying someone a basic right, denying education, denying people education in a place, denying food, people food in a place can lead to lawlessness in the society. People will start looking for food for themselves, which would cause lawlessness. We also have rigging of elections. Rigging of elections. Rigging of elections. This one I've already said can come in here through tribalism. Tribalism is not mainly through elections. That one can be different. Recently you had the people, I'm talking about this tribalism, you had different communities in the Maasai area, they were fighting one another because that is tribalism. So election also can cause, I've said, I've given an example during the 2013 election where people were being killed. We also have 2007, this was the main one, where there was the ODM and the was NAC, the one that was being led by Kibaki and the other was being led by Raila. Most of the people died during this 2007. This is true. They believe that one group believed that the election were being rigged. So that is one way, or those are just few examples of causes of lawlessness. That. Another one that I was forgetting is a poor distribution of resources. Poor distribution of resources by the government. Poor distribution of resources by the government. This leads to one area being undeveloped. This leads to one area being undeveloped. And if an area is not developed, these people would feel that they are not favored, they are being humiliated, they are not part of the government. So they have to start looking for how the government can also put them into their implementation so that they get resources. So they start maybe causing wars. There's a time where there was Mombasa, it was being said that these people from Mombasa want their own government, Pwani si Kenya, they were saying Pwani si Kenya. This is because they believe that this area, Mombasa, is being underdeveloped and developed because the government is not sending enough resources to that area. And it caused a lot of people are killing one another due to resources. This comes from the government. If the government does not distribute proper resources to some areas will feel that they are being discriminated because of that, because of the government. So they start looking for ways they can govern themselves. This will bring lawlessness in the society. So that marks the end of our lesson. I'll be sending some work back to you. Have a nice day.